Hello everyone, my name is Anushka Saxena and in this video we are going to continue reading Chemical Reactions and Equations, that is Chapter 1, Science, Class 10. So let's continue. 1.2 Types of Chemical Reactions. We have learnt in class 9 that during a chemical reaction, atoms of one element do not change into those of the other element, nor do atoms disappear from the mixture or appear from elsewhere. Actually, chemical reactions involve the breaking and making bonds between atoms to produce new substances. You will study about types of bonds formed between atoms in chapters 3 and 4. 1.2.1 Combination Reaction. Activity 1.4. Take a small amount of calcium oxide or quicklime in a beaker. Slowly add water to this. Touch the beaker as shown in figure 1.3. Do you feel any change in temperature? Calcium oxide reacts vigorously with water to produce slaked lime, calcium hydroxide, releasing a large amount of heat. That is, CaO solid, that is quicklime, plus H2O liquid gives rise to CaOH whole twice aqueous, that is slaked lime. In this reaction, calcium oxide and water combine to form a single product, calcium hydroxide. Such a reaction in which a single product is formed from two or more reactants is known as a combination reaction. Do you know, a solution of slaked lime produced by the reaction 1.13 is used for whitewashing walls. Calcium hydroxide reacts slowly with the carbon dioxide in air to form a thin layer of calcium carbonate on the walls. Calcium carbonate is formed after 2 to 3 days of whitewashing and gives a shiny finish to the walls. It is interesting to note that the chemical formula for marble is also CaCO3. The reaction is CaOH whole twice aqueous, that is calcium hydroxide, plus CO2 gaseous gives rise to CaCO3 solid, that is calcium carbonate, plus H2O liquid. Let us discuss some more examples of combination reactions. Number 1. Burning of coal. C solid plus O2 gaseous gives CO2 gaseous. Number 2. Formation of water from H2 gaseous and O2 gaseous. 2H2 gaseous plus O2 gaseous gives rise to 2H2O liquid. In simple language, we can say that when two or more substances, elements or compounds combine to form a single product, the reactions are called combination reactions. In activity 1.4, we also observe that a large amount of heat is evolved. This makes the reaction mixture warm. Reactions in which heat is released along with the formation of products are called exothermic chemical reactions. Other examples of exothermic reactions are number 1. Burning of a natural gas. CH4 gaseous plus 2O2 gaseous gives rise to CO2 gaseous plus 2H2O gaseous. Do you know that respiration is an exothermic process? We all know that we need energy to stay alive. We get this energy from the food we eat. During digestion, food is broken down into simpler substances. For example, rice, potatoes, and bread contain carbohydrates. These carbohydrates are broken down to form glucose. This glucose combines with oxygen in the cells of our body and provides energy. The special name of this reaction is respiration, the process of which you will study in chapter 6. Okay. C6H12O6 aqueous, that is glucose, plus 6O2 aqueous gives rise to 6CO2 aqueous plus 6H2O liquid plus energy. Number 3. The decomposition of vegetable matter into compost is also an example of an exothermic reaction. Identify the type of reaction taking place in activity 1.1 where heat is given out along with the formation of a single product. 1.2.2 Decomposition Reaction. Activity 1.5. Take about 2 gram ferrous sulfate crystals in a dry boiling tube. Note the color of the ferrous sulfate crystals. Heat the boiling tube over the flame of a burner or spirit lamp as shown in figure 1.4. Observe the color of the crystals after heating. Have you noticed that the green color of the ferrous sulfate crystals has changed? You can also smell the characteristic odor of burning sulfur. The reaction is 2 FeSO4 solid, that is ferrous sulfate, when heated gives rise to Fe2O3 solid, ferric oxide plus SO2 gaseous plus SO3 gaseous. In this reaction, you can observe that a single reactant breaks down to give simpler products. This is a decomposition reaction. Ferrous sulfate crystals FeSO4.7H2O lose water when heated and the color of the crystals changes. It then decomposes to ferric oxide Fe2O3, sulfur dioxide SO2 and sulfur trioxide SO3. Ferric oxide is a solid while SO2 and SO3 are gases. Decomposition of calcium carbonate to calcium oxide and carbon dioxide on heating is an important decomposition reaction used in various industries. Calcium oxide is called lime or quicklime. It has many uses. One is in the manufacture of cement. When a decomposition reaction is carried out by heating, it is called thermal decomposition. The reaction is CaCO3 solid limestone when heated gives rise to CaO solid, that is quicklime, plus CO2 gaseous. Another example of a thermal decomposition reaction is given in activity 1.6. Activity 1.6. Take about 2 gram lead nitrate powder in a boiling tube. Hold the boiling tube with a pair of tongs and heat it over a flame as shown in figure 1.5. What do you observe? Note down the change, if any. You will observe the emission of brown fumes. These fumes are of nitrogen dioxide, NO2. The reaction that takes place is 2PbNO3 whole twice solid, that is lead nitrate, when heated gives rise to 2PbO solid, that is lead oxide, plus 4NO2 gaseous, that is nitrogen dioxide, plus O2, that is oxygen, and it is gaseous. Let us perform some more decomposition reactions as given in activities 1.7 and 1.8. Activity 1.7. Take a plastic mug, drill 2 holes at its base and fit rubber stoppers in these holes. Insert carbon electrodes in these rubber stoppers as shown in figure 1.6. Connect these electrodes to a 6-volt battery. Fill the mug with water such that the electrodes are immersed. Add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid to the water. Take 2 test tubes filled with water and invert them over the 2 carbon electrodes. Switch on the current and leave the apparatus undisturbed for some time. You will observe that the formation of bubbles at both the electrodes. These bubbles displace water in the test tubes. Is the volume of the gas collected the same in both the test tubes? Once the test tubes are filled with respective gases, remove them carefully. Test these gases one by one by bringing a burning candle close to the mouth of the test tubes. This step must be performed carefully by the teacher. What happens in each case? Which gas is present in each test tube? Activity 1.8. Take about 2 gram silver chloride in a china dish. What is its color? Place this china dish in sunlight for some time. Observe the color of the silver chloride after some time. You will see that white silver chloride turns gray in sunlight. This is due to the decomposition of silver chloride into silver and chlorine by light. That is, 2AgCl solid in the presence of sunlight gives rise to 2Ag solid plus Cl2 gaseous. Silver bromide also behaves in the same way. That is, 2AgBr solid in the presence of sunlight gives rise to 2Ag solid plus Br2 gaseous. The above reactions are used in black and white photography. What form of energy is causing these decomposition reactions? We have seen that the decomposition reactions require energy either in the form of heat, light, or electricity for breaking down the reactants. Reactions in which energy is absorbed are known as endothermic reactions. 1.2.3 Displacement reaction we are going to read in the next part of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day ahead.